Hey guys, welcome to episode 2 of my Fuels Crafters Guide series. Today, we will be covering the brand new limited 5-star Quantum Harmony unit, Sparkle. Timestamps will be included in the description for easy navigation, but I hope you'll stick around for the whole duration as it does help the video in the algorithm. Let's not keep you waiting any further and get right into the guide. Sparkle is a support that specializes in a hypercarry archetype similar to Bronya, Tingyun, etc. Although not many players focus on or even care about zero cycle MOC clears, it is without a doubt that Sparkle will be an incredible asset to any zero cycle players who want to min-max their clears even further. In addition to that, for those who don't have Bronya, Sparkle is an extremely competitive alternative to Bronya, even outperforming her in many aspects. Today's guide aims to cover most of her bases, excluding her team comps, which will be covered more in depth in a separate video that will be released later today. Let's start off with Sparkle's relics. I recommend running the 4-piece ego set on her. Although it may seem the hackerspace could be better due to the team-wide speed buff, Sparkle's personal speed actually outweighs the benefits provided by hackerspace. An alternative is 4-piece hackerspace, but it's quite inferior to ego. I will only use it if the 4-piece effect helps you reach a speed threshold. If you don't have any good set pieces, or just don't feel like farming for them, going for a rainbow build is also a perfectly fine option. This is the most trail-based power efficient build as it utilizes the relics that you otherwise never use, saving you trail-based power. Generally, I recommend going for the build that results in the highest amount of speed and crit damage. Starting off with Sparkle's chest piece, there are no other options other than crit damage, since Sparkle scales directly off crit damage. For her boots, she wants speed as you want her to get as many turns as possible, ideally around 160 speed range, so she can action forward your DPSs more frequently while being able to charge her ultimate at a faster rate. For her AWP, you should run either HP or Defense main stat to increase Sparkle's survivability. Lastly, Sparkle will always want an energy regeneration rope as she gets 3 turn ultimates with it. This is the only part of her build where I will say is an absolute must. Not really much to talk about here, since it's pretty simple. You want to prioritize speed, followed by crit damage, followed by effect rest. Effect rest is important so that Sparkle is able to resist crowd control, allowing her to use her skills unimpeded. Other stats don't really matter too much, but if you could get some survivability stats like HP percent or defense percent, it's always welcome. In mono quantum teams, she would definitely want to run the Panacone set as it provides a larger buff compared to Kiehl's crit damage buff. However, if you're playing Sparkle outside of mono quantum, she would definitely want Broken Kiehl to increase her own scaling and also increase your DPS's damage. I'm sure many of you have already made this comparison before due to how similar the kits are, with both having action advance elements and scaling off crit damage. Although Sparkle's action advance looks weaker than Bronya's on paper, it actually still results in your target going directly after Sparkle as long as she is faster than them but remains less than 2 times their speed. As you can see from this clip, my Imbibitor Lune was all the way at the back of the turn order, but Sparkle pulled him all the way up. Many people underestimate Sparkle's action forward capabilities after seeing the numbers alone, but I hope this practical application showcases her action forward can indeed compete with Bronya's. Not only that, Sparkle is actually more flexible than Bronya, being able to fit in comps that Bronya would normally not be ran in. More details will be provided in my team comps video, so stay tuned for that. This is due to Sparkle's skill point positivity. since Bako has a 3-turn ultimate and generates 4 skill points, she's actually generating 1 skill point every 3 turns, or 0.33 skill point per turn. This means Sparko is providing Bronya level buffs while being SP positive, making this a truly deadly combo. In my opinion, Sparko is a direct power creep with Bronya. She not only provides similar buffs, but is also more flexible due to not being an SP drain and also working with follow-up attack units such as Jing Yuan and Dr. Ratio, since a skill's buff lasts until the start of the target's next turn. This means that units such as Jing Yuan and Dr. Ratio's follow-up attacks will be able to benefit from Sparko's skill buffs, unlike Ronya's. How the mighty have fallen. Sparko's best light cone will be her signature light cone, Earthly Escapade. It not only boosts the scaling of her own skill's buffs as it increases her crit damage, but it also gives your entire team crit rate and crit damage, allowing your DPS to have a balanced crit ratio more easily. Although this may seem very strong on Sparko, the damage increase compared to her other options mentioned later is actually not too significant. Hence, I don't really recommend pulling for it. I also want to address Earthly Escapade stacking. I know it seems really good on paper, but it actually has downtime on units that aren't Sparko, making it a downgrade compared to other options. For example, Ting Yun replacing Cox for Earthly Escapade. There will be a damage loss since the crit buff doesn't have a 100% uptime and she's losing her 3-turn ultimate. Sparko's next best slot option is actually tied between two light cones that are better than each other in different scenarios, but the battle isn't over, and dance, dance, dance. Let's talk about but the battle isn't over first. As mentioned earlier, Sparko's 50% action forward is just as good as Bronya's, allowing your DPS to go directly after Sparko. This means the uptime on but the battle isn't over's 30% damage buff is permanent, making this a very competitive option for Sparko. The other option, Dance Dance Dance, is better than but the battle isn't over if it results in Sparko going over 200 effective speed. Otherwise, but the battle isn't over would be better. A free-to-play option that is actually very good if you don't have a spare but the battle isn't over will be Past and Future, since its merits are similar to but the battle isn't over's, just without the extra skill point on the ultimate. TLDR, use but the battle isn't over or Past and Future if Sparko's effective speed is under 200. Use Dance 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 if it can push her over 200 speed. Use Earthly Escapade in all scenarios if you have it. Quite simple here, you want to upgrade her skill followed by ultimate or talent, whichever you prefer, since they have equal priority. I don't recommend upgrading her basic attack at all. For her major chases, it will be her A4, followed by A6, followed by A2. Also very simple, with 3 skills on energy regeneration rope, Sparko is able to generate 113.43 energy, allowing her to cast her ultimate every 3 turns. On a non-energy regeneration rope, she'll need 4 turns to cast her ultimate, hence an energy regeneration rope is a must. Overall, I do think that Sparko will be an amazing addition to the game, being a mini Bronya that's SP positive and more flexible. Her pulling value is a definite 10 out of 10 if you're an Imbibed Lune / Mono Quantum / follow-up attack user. Otherwise, her value is an 8 out of 10. Very solid unit and very worth your pulls. Anyway, I've yapped enough for today. Make sure to check out my socials in the description below. I try to stream 3-4 times a week, schedule will be uploaded in my Discord server. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment sharing your opinions on Sparko. I hope you guys enjoyed today's content, and I'll see you around soon.